these are the topics involved in first year. In second year, you will have circles, parabola, ellipse, and hyperbola. Okay? And this, the first one is coordinates. But already you know what is meant by x coordinate, what is meant by y coordinate, all that. And now, Vignesh. So, Vignesh.
Sir, in which volume it is there, sir?
So, first let me complete the introduction, Vignesh.
Okay, sir.
So, Vignal Kalgista Venduku start cheyangane. So, chudu edo volume lo untundi. Volume chuste ela untundi. See, volume 3.
Okay, sir.
Right. So, in coordinates, I think everybody knows about coordinates. So, no need to introduce coordinates. So, I will directly go to distance between two points. And see, this is capital A. It has two coordinates, x1, y1. So, anybody don't know about coordinates? I think everybody knows. Harshit?
Sir? Sir, yesterday J mains and J advanced paper, I have two doubts, sir.
Okay, definitely I will explain. But first let me complete some introduction. If I complete introduction, so you have some problems to do today.
Okay.
So tomorrow you can explain that. Meanwhile, our principal sir will send you those papers and solutions also. So everybody thoroughly see that. If you have any doubts, if you are ready with that, tomorrow I can explain. So no problem. See.
Okay.
Another one. So I think Madan. Madan. Madan.
Hello, sir.
Sir,
till now what you taught? Because of internet connection, I couldn't listen, sir.
No, I didn't start anything. Just only I'm starting. See, two points are there. Two points are there, x1, y1 and x2, y2. We have to find the distance between them. So in our earlier classes, just we have taken some scale or like that and find the distance between them. But here, if x coordinate and y coordinate are given for both the points, how to find the distance? Actually, what is meant by x coordinate? If you draw perpendicular to x axis from this point, the distance from origin to this point is x coordinate. And this perpendicular distance is called y coordinate, y1. Similarly, if you draw the perpendicular, this distance is x coordinate, x2, and this distance is y coordinate, y2. Right? And draw perpendicular from A to this side. So, to that perpendicular, so draw another perpendicular from A. I mean, draw a line parallel to x axis from the point A. It intersects this line at that point. Okay, let it be some C, this is D, and this is E. Now I want to find the length AB. See, this triangle is right angle triangle, and therefore using Pythagoras theorem, AB square is equal to BC square, or this one is AC square plus BC square. So to find AB, it is enough to find AC and BC. And see now, what is this length? Y2. What is this length? Y1. So this length is also y1 because it is a rectangle. So this is y1. And therefore tell me, this is y2 and this is y1. So what is this distance? So the distance BC is equal to total distance y2 minus this distance y1. So y2 minus y1. Similarly, what is this length? Because it is a rectangle, this distance is equal to this distance. And what is this length? So from origin to E, x2. From origin to D, x1. So this length is x2 minus x1. Because these two are equal, this is also x2 minus x1. okay, and therefore AB square is equal to AC square, that is H2 minus X1 whole square. See, AB square is equal to X2 minus X1 whole square plus this one Y2 minus Y1 whole square. And we get an important formula, that is distance between two points AB, that is square root of H2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. That is the first formula of coordinate geometry, but a very, very important formula. So it will come at least some 10,000 times in these 2 years. Okay, so you have to remember that formula. Write down that first formula. The distance between the points, the distance between the points capital A X1 Y1 and capital B X2 comma Y2 is denoted by AB. Is denoted by AB. And AB is equal to square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Under root, that is AB is equal to square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Nice. Then what is distance from origin to any point? What are the coordinates of origin? 0, 0. Suppose capital A is X comma Y. So what is the distance between these two points? That is OA is equal to what? Square root of X minus 0 whole square, X square, plus Y minus 0 whole square, Y square. So this is distance between, this is distance from origin to the point A, X comma Y. Right on. The distance from origin, the distance from origin to the points capital A, X comma Y, X comma Y is denoted by OA is equal to square root of X square plus Y square. Okay, so with this formula only you can do so many problems. So is that Ratnasekhar? Ratnasekhar?
Good afternoon, sir. Ratnasekhar, I joined just now. Are you explaining coordinate geometry?
Yes, yes. So very first formula is square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. You know that? And this,
sir,
is second
from
one.
Origin, right, sir?
Root O means origin. OA is root X square plus Y square.
Okay, sir.
Right?
Sir, and today onwards, you started just now.
Just now only coordinate geometry started.
Okay, sir.
Right. And suppose now 3 points are given. Capital A, X1, Y1, and capital B, X2, Y2, and capital C, X3, Y3. And now you have to verify whether those 3 points are collinear or not. What is meant by collinear? If 3 points lie on a straight line, then we say that they are collinear points. Okay. And actually in the plane geometry, we have to locate those 3 points and we have to see whether they are parallel or not, they are collinear or not. But here you simply find the distances. See, suppose A, B, C are like this. Suppose A is here, B is here, C is here. If at all they are collinear like this, see, AB distance plus BC distance is equal to what? AC. If sum of two distances is equal to third distance, definitely we say that they are collinear. But suppose the naming is not important. Suppose like this, DCA is like this. Then what happens? DC plus CA is equal to AB. So sum of two distances must be equal to third distance. Or it may be like this: AB plus AC is equal to BC. Okay, add up 3 points. Capital A comma capital B comma capital C are collinear. Are collinear if write this. Akash.
Sir, and if area is also equal to zero, then also we can say that the lines are collinear.
There are so many ways to prove 3 points are collinear. This is one of the ways. So when area then, comes into play, we can discuss about that also. Very good. Right. That is also true. Okay.
Sir, and can you explain that how AB plus BC is equal to AC? First point. AB, sir, first line, sir. AB plus BC is equal to AC.
Now you see, Akash, ABC, AB plus BC is equal to AC, isn't it?
Okay, sir. Sir, I thought in that diagram.
No. That diagram is for this. BC plus CA is equal to BA. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right. So all three cannot happen at the same time. Exactly one of them happens. If exactly one of them happens, then we say that those 3 points are collinear. But all three didn't happen, then we can clearly say that they are not collinear. They won't lie on a straight line. So whenever they don't lie on a straight line means definitely they form a triangle. Definitely they form a triangle. See, A, B, C. Now the question is, what type of triangle it is? Is it equilateral triangle? Is it isosceles triangle? Like that, he may ask. So what we have to check? So just find the distances AB. Since the points AX1, Y1, BX2, Y2 and CX3, Y3. Since the 3 points are given, you can find the distances AB, BC, and CA, and you can say it is equilateral triangle. So when you can say it is equilateral triangle, then you can say that is equilateral triangle, all sides are equal, that is AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. Right. Now isosceles triangle. So, if at least two sides are equal, then it is called isosceles triangle. So, you can verify AB is equal to BC or AC is equal to BC or AB is equal to AC. If at least one of them happens, then we can say that is isosceles triangle. And what is meant by scalene? If all the three sides have different lengths, then it is called scalene. That means AB is not equal to BC, BC is not equal to CA, and CA is not equal to AB. And we can say that the triangle is called scalene. So write those points. So just by finding the distances, I mean lengths, using the points, we can decide whether it is equilateral, isosceles, or scalene. So equilateral means all sides are equal. Isosceles means two sides are equal at least. Scallion means so all the three sides have different lengths. And now tell me any doubts. Snehita has some doubts. Snehita.
Sir, can we say whether it is acute angled or obtuse angled or right angled?
Yes, yes, yes. The next discussion is that only.
Okay, sir.
And now this is relating to sides, but relating to angles, there are another three definitions of triangles. One is right angled triangle. So capital A, capital B, capital C. So it is called right angled triangle. Actually, what is the definition of right angled triangle? One angle is 90 degrees. If one angle is 90 degrees, then the triangle is called right angled triangle. And second one, acute angled triangle. Actually, what is meant by acute angle? An angle which lies in between 0 degrees and 90 degrees is called acute angle. If all the three angles are acute angle, just like 60, 60, 60, 60, 50, 70, like that, if all the three angles are acute angles, then it is called acute angled triangle, right? And now what about obtuse angled triangle? What about obtuse angled triangle? If one angle is obtuse, what is meant by obtuse? An angle which lies in between 90 degrees and 180 degrees is called obtuse angle. Therefore, if one angle is obtuse, that means automatically the two angles must be acute. So if one is obtuse, two angles are acute, then it is called obtuse angle triangle. So based on angles, they are defined like that. But we don't know angles, just the points are given. So capital A x1 y1, capital B x2 y2, and capital C x3 y3, the points are given. So how to decide using the points? Again, find the distances. So find the distances AB, BC, AC, and verify Pythagoras theorem. If some of the squares of the two sides is square of the third side, for example, in this triangle, in this diagram, see AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Now the letters are not important. Remember the sentences. Some of the squares of the two sides, suppose if the letters are A, B, C, then what you have to write A, B square plus A, C square is equal to B, C square, like that. So some of the squares of the two sides is square of the third side, then it is called right angled triangle. And what is meant by acute angle triangle? All angles are acute angles. Then how to decide? Again find the distances A, B, B, C, A, C. And now some of the two squares, that is AB square plus BC square greater than AC square, and AB square plus AC square greater than BC square, and also BC square plus AC square greater than AB square. So what is the condition? Sum of the squares of the two sides must be greater than square of the third side. All three should happen simultaneously. So if all the three happens, then we can say that acute angle triangle, right? And now obtuse angle triangle. Why we have to admit like this means, now if you know cos rule and properties of triangles, you can understand, but no problem, you can remember this. But what is meant by obtuse angle triangle? One angle is obtuse angle. Therefore, in these three inequalities, one must be less than, so here greater than. Suppose see, this triangle is obtuse angle triangle because this angle is greater than 90 degrees. For example, this is B, this is A, and this is C. And see, now AB square plus BC square, AB square plus BC square less than AC square. But the remaining two angles are acute, therefore, for the remaining two, AC square plus BC square greater than AB square, you will get and AB square plus AC square greater than BC square limitations. So for two, you should get greater than. For one, you get less than. Then it is called obtuse angle. All the three are greater than, that is acute angle. For two, greater than, and for one is equal to, then you will get right angle triangle. Okay, so write down that information. Pushkar.
Sir, I cannot see down part, sir.
You cannot see down part. Okay. Now?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Sridhar?
No, sir. Same problem, sir.
Okay. So, then lower your hands. Pushkar, lower your hand. Right. Akash?
Sir, for obtuse angle, all these three conditions should be satisfied at the same time.
All three conditions means?
Sir, AB square plus BC square is less than AC square.
Mm.
And sir, other two also.
Other two means this greater than, okay?
Yes, sir. Sir, at the same time, sir.
Same time.
Okay,
same
sir.
Same time, obviously. Whenever the three points are not collinear, suppose you observe for one that is equal to, definitely it will be right angle triangle. No need to verify the other two. Definitely for the other two, it will be greater than. Similarly, if you observe one is less than, if they are not collinear, definitely the other two will be greater than. No need to verify. But if you get one is greater than, you have to check the other two. Second one is greater than. You have to check the third one. Third one is also greater than, then definitely it will be acute angle triangle.
Okay, sir.
And special types of quadrilaterals. See, this is parallelogram and this is rhombus. And this is rectangle and this is square. So what is the definition of parallelogram actually? Just opposite sides are parallel and equal. And what is the definition of rhombus? All sides are equal. What is the definition of rectangle? All angles are equal, 90 degrees. And what is the definition of square? All sides are equal and all angles are also equal. Okay, that means every square you can call a rhombus because here all sides are equal. Every square you can call a rectangle because all angles are 90 degrees like this. But x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, x4, y4. Then how to decide whether it is a parallelogram? Or rhombus or rectangle or square. So how to decide? And now you find all the sides. You find all the sides. So that is, find the distances AB, BC, CD, DA. Find all the sides. If all the four sides are equal, then definitely you cannot conclude anything, because if all sides are equal, it may be rhombus also. AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. Definitely we can say it is not rectangle and it is not parallelogram. Right. But what about that? So how to decide among these two? Now find the diagonals. If AC is equal to BD, if the diagonals are also equal, then it is called square. If the diagonals are not equal, this is a rhombus but not square. So what is the condition for rhombus but not square? All sides are equal, diagonals are equal, not equal. So what is the condition for square? All sides are equal and the diagonals are also equal. And then you observe that all sides are not equal, but just only opposite sides are equal. That is AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AB. And immediately you cannot conclude anything because here also AB is equal to CD, BC is equal to AD. And now again as in the previous case, find the diagonal lengths. If AC is equal to BD, then definitely that is a rectangle. If AC not equal to BD, there is only a parallelogram but not a rectangle. Okay, draw these diagrams. So be careful students, I am not saying that this is the only condition for parallelogram. This is the condition for parallelogram only. That means it cannot be a rectangle, it cannot be a rhombus, it cannot be a square like that. Actually, this is a parallelogram also. What is the definition of parallelogram? If you go for the textbook definitions or if you seek Google, so what a parallelogram definition will appear? Opposite sides are parallel and equal. That means definitely opposite sides are parallel and equal. So every square is a parallelogram, every rectangle is a parallelogram, every rhombus is a parallelogram. And this is a parallel. You just tell me one thing. Is it a quadrilateral or not? What is the definition of quadrilateral? If it has four sides, it is a quadrilateral. Yes, it has four sides. So it is a quadrilateral. Can you say that? No, no, sir. It's not quadrilateral, sir. It is a square, sir. You say like that. Okay. Suppose whether anybody asked me, so whether you are a human being or not means, no, no, I am a man. I am not a human being. I will tell like that. No. I'm a human being. In addition to that, I'm a man. So just like that, here also, so it is a square. Apart from it is a quadrilateral, it is a parallelogram also. No doubt it is a rhombus. Four sides are equal. No doubt it is rectangle. All angles are equal. But I'm not writing those conditions here. I'm writing those conditions for objective type. Suppose four points are given. Four points are given. And in the options, it is given like that. It is a parallelogram but not rhombus. Rhombus but not square. Rectangle but not square. And square. And now how to decide means simply find the four lengths, lengths of the sides, and also find the diagonal lengths. Then using these conditions, you can decide which diagram is that one. Okay, students. And now tell me if you have any doubts. Oh, so many students raises their hands. So first of all, Mohan Krishna, isn't it? So Mohan Krishna? No. Shake.
Sir, we can't see upper part, sir.
That's the problem. That is the problem. Okay. Right, see.
Yes, sir. Now, okay.
Now you write first part.
Yes, sir.
Now for parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, AB is equal to CD, BC is equal to AD. But diagonals are not equal, AC not equal to BD. That is, it is strictly, it is a parallelogram, but neither a square nor a rectangle like that. Now write the remaining ones. Meanwhile, I can ask the doubts. So if you have any. Madan.
Hello, sir.
Madan.
Sir, for parallelogram, it is enough for saying that
if in quadrilateral opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are also equal, both are single only, sir. If opposite sides are parallel, then we can say that it is parallelogram only, na, sir.
Yes, definitely.
One condition also can be satisfied, na, sir.
If opposite sides are parallel, definitely they are equal also. Okay.
Yes.
Right. But to find the lengths, it is not sufficient to say parallel. That's why I am saying parallel and equal. Right. And next one, section formula. So what is that section formula? Suppose two points are there, A and B. Its coordinates are x1, y1. Its coordinates are x2, y2. And there is a point P in between them, in the line segment AB, such that P divides A and B in the ratio m is to n. Then what is the coordinates of P? What is the coordinates of P? So there is a formula. Once again, we can prove just in the previous case of distance between two points using the similar triangles like that. But no proof is needed. Simply remember the formula. So P is equal to, see this one, mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, comma my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. Okay, students, so this is the formula to find a point which divides the line segment joining A and B in the ratio m is to n internally. Suppose, see students, suppose this is 2, this is 1. Suppose this is 2 kilometers, this is 1 kilometer. Or this is 2 lakhs kilometers, this is 1 lakh kilometer. That means the ratio is 2:1 only. Then you can find this formula, using this formula, you can find this point. So 2x2 plus 1x1 by m plus n, like this. But see, there is another point on this line. Suppose there is another point Q here, such that the distance from A to Q is some 2 units or some 20 kilometers. Distance from B to Q is 10 kilometers. And now tell me, what is that ratio? 20:10. That is once again 2:1. So if there is 2:1 ratio point is in between A and B, there is a point, then definitely there will be another point on this line only, which divides again these two points in the ratio 2:1, but it is outside the line segment A and B. This is inside, in between A and B, that is outside the line segment A and B. So this is called, it is dividing internally the points A and B. This is externally dividing the points A and B. Therefore, how to find the coordinates? So same for 90% same, just only the difference is you have to put minus here. mx2 minus nx1 by minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. Okay, so these are the two formulae. So you have to remember these two also. Write down the formulae. The point P, which it divides, the line segment joining the points capital A x1 comma y1 and capital B x2 comma y2 in the ratio in the ratio m is to n, m is to n internally is given by, so first write this formula, next the point Q, the point Q which divides the line joining the points, the line joining the points capital A x1 y1 and capital B x2 y2 in the ratio m is to n externally is given by Q mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n comma my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. Okay students, so whenever you see the word internally, use this formula. Whenever you see the word externally, use this formula. Suppose no word like that is used, internally or externally, but only the ratio is given like that. The ratio 3 is to 2. Generally we take for internal points. And now see this one. Suppose the ratio is 3 is to minus 2. It is given like that. And this is the indication for external points. So there is one minus here, either 3 is to minus 2 or minus 3 is to 2. So that is indication for external point. And then you can use this formula, but consider the numbers m and n as 3 and 2, not minus 3 and 2. So if you want to use minus 3, now you have to put here only. Okay, otherwise, so just use external formula. Mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n like that. So by erasing this minus, just taking 3 is to 2. So whenever there is a minus, you can understand that that is an external point. Right? And see, there is an internal point in between A and B, and exactly in between A and B. That is called midpoint, you know. And what is the formula for midpoint? A x1 y1, B x2 y2. And this is the midpoint. Midpoint means it divides that line segment in the ratio 1 is to 1. And therefore, what is the formula? 1x2 plus 1x1. Simply x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay. So write down that formula. The midpoint of the line segment. The midpoint of the line segment joining capital A x1 by 1 and capital B x2 by 2 is x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay, students.